Hey guys, it's Hannah. Welcome back to the channel. We're doing another Q&A. I did one a few months ago.
Here we are again.
I've been posting a lot of vlogs lately, which are very fun, but I also like talking to you guys and just breaking things down. So let's do that. So I asked you guys on Instagram if you had any questions for me. I just posted this, so let's see. Okay, how did you meet Dean, Jack, and Truckee? Right off the bat. So basically, we were on the beach, and these two guys came up to all three of us, and they were like,
hey, are you Lexi?
And then they were like joking around asking Lexi for pictures, and I got up to take the picture, and then they're like,
no, we're just kidding. We wanted to invite you guys over for dinner.
So we were gonna go get tacos with them, but we ended up going over and just hanging out with them, and their whole friend group, there were like eight guys and like three of us, and we just ended up clicking. That's like the short story of it, like summed up really fast. And then Truckee just lived like a couple houses down from them, and so then we ended up like all becoming friends with Truckee too. Best mascara,
this is the kind that I use. I'll go get it.
We're really gonna be hopping between topics here. There's gonna be a lot that's going on, but I use Bad Gal Bang.
It's honestly amazing. You guys came here for like a Q&A and now you're getting a makeup tutorial.
I'll link it down below for you guys if you want. If you weren't in Hawaii right now, what do you think you would be doing? I'd probably be doing the same thing. I have been making videos for 7 years. So like if I was still in Michigan right now, like I would still be making videos and working on Starlight. I don't even know if I would be in Michigan right now, but like I'd probably just be somewhere else doing the same thing. How are you doing mentally? Well, it's funny you ask that because I'm doing great. Mentally, I have been doing, I feel like my head is clear, like I'm the most confident that I've ever been. And obviously like life happens, like things happen. I still get in sad moods. You guys probably just don't see that because I choose not to post sad moments. How do you manage your time? You do lots of things during the day. This is a great question because I still don't know. I bought a planner. I've tried to start like an online planner and I can't do it. I would say I'm a very unorganized person, but I know what I need to get done and I get it done. It's just like there's no, how do you deal with stress? I feel like stress or anxiety, what helps with that is just like maybe writing down a to-do list of things that you need to get done or things you've been avoiding. Taking a deep breath, setting your phone down. I feel like if I get stressed out, it's because there's so much going on in my head and I don't even know where to start. So that's when I like bust out the planner and then I'll like write things down. Have you made a lot of new friends in Hawaii? I think I definitely have made some lifelong friends here. Some of them are already back home, like, and they were visiting, but I feel like I definitely have made some amazing friendships. I'm very, very grateful for that. Can you please make your videos at least 20 minutes? I will try. I've been trying to make my videos longer because I honestly like longer videos too, because I like to sit down and get a snack and watch. I don't know if you guys like to do that. Like, who are your comfort eating YouTubers? Like, who do you watch when you eat? I like watching Danny Duncan. I like watching Cody Ko. I like watching Alicia Marie. Like, those are like my three like comfort YouTubers that I watch all the time. Do you ever get homesick? I definitely do. I miss my family. I miss my friends. I miss my siblings. And whenever I do, I call them, I FaceTime them. I talk to someone from my family or someone from my hometown at least once a day. And I'm going back this summer for a little bit to see everyone because I miss them. But yeah, I still really value like my friends and my life here too, but I do get homesick at times. How have you gained more confidence in your body? I feel like that just comes with like loving yourself and realizing like I am who I am, and if you don't like me then you can leave. Like, that's kind of my attitude. My body is my body and I love my body, and my personality is my personality, and like I'm sorry if you don't like me, like that's your problem. Are you planning to do a podcast? I feel like everyone started podcasts recently. I do like to listen to podcasts every once in a while, especially when I'm driving. I don't know. I think podcasts would be fun, but I also like this. Like, I feel like this kind of sort of feels like a podcast. Almost. Do you plan on traveling to other islands? I did go to the Big Island to visit my grandparents, which was fun, but I've really just been chilling here. I do have plans to go to another island with my friends. We're actually getting COVID tested this week and then we're going later. How do you maintain your weight and stay in shape? I feel like just doing something active every day is one, important, but two, I like to drink a lot of water, and I feel like I try not to snack after dinner just because when I feel gross when I wake up the next morning anyways, if I do like a late night snack. But like last night we had popcorn and chocolate and watched New Girl in bed, me, Lexi, and Meredith. What's the best advice you've ever been given? We were watching New Girl and Jess, the main character, goes, "The only way to get through it is to get through it." And I thought that was just like, but it's so true. Like, you can't get over your problems and you can't get through your problems unless you like keep working to get through them, and eventually those problems are gonna be gone. So like the only way to get through it is to keep pushing. Okay, so this is kind of a recent question that I didn't necessarily know how I was going to address, but it's, are you dating Dean? Yes, Dean and I are dating. Just doesn't feel right saying that because I was gonna tell you guys, I just didn't know the right moment. I was gonna tell you guys when I was ready and when he was ready, because videoing things is my life. My friends video a lot too. And it's like scary to be around that because you never know what you say or what's filmed, if that's gonna go public. But basically what happened is, footage of us got leaked. Lexi has an editor, and so she was vlogging all this stuff, as one does when you are an influencer. And she put all the footage on a Google Drive, and she was filming a TikTok, and it accidentally, she had the link in there, and so people typed up the link, and they downloaded the footage, a couple clips that were in the vlog. And there's videos of Dean and I kissing in some of those clips, and someone chose to take those clips and put them online, which you guys, a lot of you, thank you. For those of you who DM me about it, it's out there. I'll show you the leaked clips now so you don't have to go look for them. Like, they're out now. I'll put them here.
Cut this out.
I forgot.
No one sees.
You got Nolan. This is for you, baby.
Nolan.
We are disgusting and sweaty, and we want to make a scene at the restaurant.
No. Do you get it?
Okay, I don't.
It was so cute.
Oh. So clearly, like, this was not how I planned on telling you guys. And I was super excited to share the relationship with you guys when we were both ready. But unfortunately, it happened like this. Like, I'm a normal person. He's a normal person. You guys are all normal people. At the end of the day, nobody wants, like, their private moments that they don't want shared online by someone else. Like, that's not cool. And for those of you that were DMing me, like, thank you so much. It honestly means a lot, because a lot of people are like, I'm so sorry, this is so messed up, that people literally like felt the need to download the link. Like, clearly it was an accident, download the footage and post that. People don't understand that level of privacy, but anything to get views these days, right? I'm trying to be respectful of the people that are in my personal and private life. But yeah, just because I video things does not mean I want everything shared. Was it hard to convince Mayor to move to Hawaii? So, Mayor, wait, do you want to come up here?
Sure.
Basically, it wasn't hard, but I kind of told her, I was like, I'm going and I really want you to come and it's up to you, but like, just know I'm going and I really want you to. And so she kind of had to make the decision on her own. Introducing Meredith. What's going through your mind?
Basically, she asked me if I wanted to move to Hawaii with her for 2 months, and I was like, no, that's ridiculous.
I'm not doing that. Like, I was very like, no.
I started with the 2 months.
And then she was like, how about a month? And I was like, maybe, but like, no. And I kept telling her no, but then in the back of my mind, I was like, somehow, some way, I know I'm gonna end up out there, and here we are, so.
How does Mary feel about Josh's announcement?
I'm very happy for her.
So yeah, Meredith had like the biggest crush on Joshua Bassett, and he just came out as gay, which, yes, Josh, we love you.
I feel bad, I'm like,
cause we Josh, like, would always go on his lives and comment on his lives and be like, Josh, we love you, like, Meredith, like, talk to Meredith, like.
We would harass him so much, and I feel so bad because
we really just wanted Josh to give Meredith a chance, and he never did. He never opened my DMs, he never opened her DMs, but it makes sense now, I guess.
Yeah, it makes sense, and we're happy for you.
And no, we are. No, and we still want you to be friends with us, Josh.
Now we just
want to
be friends.
If you're watching.
Just friends.
How to deal with negative comments on social media. I don't know. I feel like it always sucks getting negative comments, but also, like, who's commenting that? Like, why are you commenting stuff? If it's, like, constructive criticism, totally, that's always great. But if it's, like, mean for no reason and, like, bullying and just, like, I don't understand. Do you, Mare, and Lexi fight often? This is a good question because we definitely have fought and we've definitely had to have some talks and some heart-to-hearts, but that's what you get when you like live with all the girls. We all work and kind of are in the same, obviously, social media industry. Obviously, there's stuff that happens with friends,
boys, living situations. Like, I like that we talk about stuff and aren't like passive aggressive. Like, I think at the end of the day, it's just all about like respecting each other and hearing what the other person has to say and like going from there. Are you vaccinated? No, I'm not vaccinated yet. I am going to get vaccinated in the very near future though. What prompted you to move to Hawaii? Obviously, kind of like I said, I was doing YouTube, working on my business, and I was doing school. And I also just had some things going on at home where it wasn't the best. I think like a lot of people think it's like a casual thing, like that I just like packed up and left, but I was thinking about it for a while. And I honestly don't mean to promote it to look like this easy thing to do, because it's definitely not easy. Like, it was not easy to, you know, sell all my stuff at home, sell my car, sell my clothes, pay off my apartment back at home and get that all taken care of, and then rent a new place here, buy a car here. Like, I make it look all like fun and games online, but it's definitely a lot harder than it looks to pack up and move somewhere, which I'm even amazed that I did that. And like, I have these amazing friends and this amazing home. I love it here. I'm learning more about the culture every single day and doing what I can to respect that. Are you happier in Hawaii? Love your vids. Thank you. And I don't know if it's Hawaii. I'm sure a little bit of it is, because it's like, obviously it's paradise here, but I'm more so just so happy with the people I have in my life. I think a new environment was so important for me. And so I definitely become a much happier person with like all the changes that my life has went through recently. Did you sell the Range Rover? Yeah, my dad actually sold it for me. Thank you, Dad. I love you. Do you have a Depop? You guys know Nolan, one of my best friends. He cleaned out my apartment. I said, hey, you can clean out my apartment and you can take all of my clothes and you can literally have my Depop and sell them and just take all the money that you make from there if you just like clean out my apartment. So yeah, if you guys want to go buy some of my old clothes, they are up on Depop, and all of the money goes in Nolan's pocket. And so I'm like, give that boy some money because I want him to come back out here at some point. Yeah, I think it's so cute how he sells them. He sends me like little pictures of him shipping out the packages. All right, so that's, I feel like, a good amount of the questions. I answered a lot of the questions. We had some repeats, but I feel like hopefully I answered your questions and I hope you guys enjoyed. I will see you Monday. Make sure you subscribe, turn post notifications on. Yeah, I love you. Let me know if you guys want more like sit down videos like this. And I will see you Monday. Bye.